Hello Creative Venus community. Today I am going to share how I achieved this design using Spline 3D. It's awesome, and you will love it. I always use a lot of tools and give each one a try to enrich my passion for creating awesome presentations and storytelling. Spline 3D is a great addition to my experience with PowerPoint, Affinity Designer, Illustrator, and Figma. It offers this amazing 3D experience that is incredibly versatile. I just love it. Now, let's learn how to design this awesome looking UI for your presentation. Every presentation starts with a background. Insert a rectangle and draw it, keeping the resolution at 1920 by 1080. How about making it in portrait mode? Just rotate it by 90 degrees, and now it looks fine. Apply the color to the background. In Spline 3D, it is called materials. You can apply various types of materials to any surface. However, for the background, we only need a dark color. The background is ready. Let's add the text layer on top of it. What makes a beautiful design different from standard design is how much effort you put into every single element. For a beginner, it might be easy to put a text box and paste the complete sentence in it. However, we will do it differently. I have added three different text boxes to fill three words of the sentence, with one word in each line. This is called text styling, and it is very important to learn. Additionally, you might want to give a different color to an important word in the sentence. After this, I have added the branding at the top. Instead of using a new text box each time, I am duplicating the existing one to save time and effort. As you can see, I take the time to adjust every bit of text. It is essential to give attention to every single element. The details are important. And one more thing, keep trying and deleting. The more mistakes you make, the more you will learn. Now, it is looking much better. Just adjust the placement of the text and keep it at the center. Spaced out alphabets look good in sentences. It makes any title look better. You might have a different opinion. What's next? I forgot to change the color of the important word, which is awesome. So again, you have to play with the material option. It is an interesting task to create different materials for various surfaces. Now, let's insert a glass cube. To do that, insert a cube from the top section and apply a material. Here, you have the opportunity to be creative. Materials in Spline 3D are very easy to create once you learn how to use them. Material creation in 3D design is indeed a satisfying and creative task. It allows you to craft various surface layers to apply on objects, giving you the flexibility to simulate a wide range of materials such as metallic, glass, wood, solid, and many more. The ability to customize each material based on different options adds another layer of creativity to the process. Experimenting with different materials, trying out various settings, and seeing how they interact with light and the environment is a hands-on way to learn and refine your skills. The favorites, like glass and metallic materials, often produce stunning visual effects with their natural shine and gradient colors. Additionally, the ability to create, test, and save materials for later use is a valuable feature. This allows designers to build a library of materials that work well for their specific projects and styles. Material creation is, indeed, a hands-on and exploratory aspect of 3D design that allows for a lot of personal expression and artistic interpretation. It's a part of the creative process that encourages continuous experimentation and improvement. You also need to understand the theme of your design. The materials should be in sync with the theme. Another aspect is that each material has its own options, so what I am trying to convey is that materials are a subject in themselves to study and learn. After some testing, I have found some settings that suit me for the kind of designs I create. Find Spline 3D to be one of the easiest 3D platforms for learning and testing designs. It's interactive, allowing you to build 3D presentations and even games. With added AI features, it enhances your creativity. It stands out as one of the most balanced tools for designing 3D elements. In this video, I'm not just providing a tutorial, I'm sharing the experience. Basic actions like inserting shapes, applying colors, alignments, text, etc., are common across tools, with only their placements and scopes changing. Therefore, my focus is more on the experiential aspect of the tutorial. Now, the cube looks nice, and the glass material I picked from the library is amazing. You can further customize the material as per the requirement. But for now, this is nice. Now, we just need to increase the blurriness so that the text behind the cube blurs. Now, only two things are pending. One is applying the animation or events, as we call them in Spline 3D. The other pending task is configuring the export settings. Let's start with the export settings. I don't want users to zoom in, scroll, or drag the area. I want the scene to be locked, and only the cube should move or animate. To achieve this, click on Export and update the settings by selecting the relevant options. Disallow the options for zoom, scroll, etc. Take your time to review the settings and update them as required. Now, we need to apply the animation effect, and it's very straightforward in Spline 3D. It's called Events. I want the cube to move in sync with the mouse movement. It should stay at its current position but just rotate while looking at the mouse. For this, add a new event and then look for the option. Look at. Click on it and update the settings. Test it a few times before you get the desired results. Once satisfied, apply it. Here are the settings, and you can change them as per the axis. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something new. With this tool, you can create amazing experiences. While it takes some time, the results are truly incredible. Keep watching our videos, and we will see you in the next one.